Welcome to the Best of Beaver County, presented by St. Barnabas, a weekly segment dedicated to putting the focus on the amazing things and the amazing people behind them in Beaver County. The Best of Beaver County is sponsored by and content is provided by St. Barnabas. The show airs every Thursday from 11 to 11:30 on WBBP, WMBA, 99.3 FM, and Facebook Live. Now, with no further ado, let's welcome host Mike Romigh to introduce today's program.
Welcome to the Best of Beaver County radio show on the St. Barnabas Radio Network. Since 1900 and counting, St. Barnabas has been focused on increasing the quality of life by caring for people in southwest Pennsylvania. Today, in Allegheny, Beaver, and Butler counties, we offer a full continuum of care for our residents, patients, and retirement communities. The St. Barnabas Health System has developed into a visionary leader in the healthcare industry through compassionate and quality care, offering an array of unparalleled health services from skilled nursing to extensive memory care activities and programs. Additionally, the St. Barnabas Medical Center has world-class doctor and dentistry teams where patients can receive a full range of services under one roof that also include rehabilitation, home health and home care, hospice care, and palliative care. In building upon its heritage, St. Barnabas continues to reach those in need and lives out its mission through individual and institutional services that promote the health, education, and social needs of others. Men and women are invited to join in the work of Christian caring, healing, and teaching as we bear witness to our founder's reminder, God is able. In offering solutions and opportunities to enhance the daily lives of our residents, patients, and retirement community members, we're excited to bring you today's guest. In a recent conversation, we spoke about diet, memory care, exercise, and seasonal affective disorder. You know, the New Year's resolution stuff, which, by the way, it's still not too late. Some people have already broken their New Year's resolutions. As we speak with today's guest, who will pull it all together for us, please join me in welcoming Chris Cosky. Chris is the owner of Be Well Nation and an exercise specialist who is approaching fitness with a new perspective. Welcome back, Chris.
Thanks. It's great to be here. Happy New Year.
Wonderful to have you on today.
Thanks.
And many of our viewers and listeners don't know, I should have just handed this to you because you read a lot of the copy for St. Barnabas.
Sometimes, yeah.
Yeah. Well, you were Jill or Judy and somebody, right? Yeah, do that. So when you hear some of those St. Barnabas commercials, Chris is the voice behind it all.
Very happy to do it. It's fun. It's fun to be able to tip my toe back in.
Well, and she says back in because Chris was a member of the broadcast neighborhood for many years.
Yeah.
Right? Doing
20 years.
What, soft rock or rock and roll or
yes
country?
And yes. And yes,
all the different,
and yes.
All the different formats that have come around forever. And you've parlayed that into health and fitness, which is remarkable. Tell us a little bit about yourself. Unless you wanted to just start off and we'd get up and do Zumba or something like that.
Careful what you wish for. Careful. I'm always prepared.
Yeah.
You know what? You talked about New Year's resolutions, and we will go there because, man, I have such mixed feelings about New Year's resolutions. For many years, the line of thinking has been, don't do that. Don't do that.
The pressure is on.
Because they're just made to be broken, right? We set these lofty goals, these unrealistic expectations. So don't even do that. Yet, isn't that really human nature at the beginning of a year to want to start fresh, to want to turn a page, to want to do something? I feel like that's just part of who we are as people.
Yeah.
So to deny that and say, oh, don't do those things. So when we talk about it later, I just want to say, I'm not a fan of the traditional New Year's resolution, but I'd like to give you some thought starters and some action plans on how you, if you feel that calling to turn that page, that we can help you out with that. So I'll just
so the pressure is on, and this is January 26th already, and you broke your New Year's resolution.
Well, you might have.
Because today's Pi Day.
Well, so you might have broke it because it was a little unrealistic or the goal was a little too lofty or you didn't have the plan in place to support it. But the other thing is, you know, maybe you've spent the month looking around. So maybe you haven't even made that decision yet. And that's what I've found. You know, the first year that I owned Be Well in 2016, I was like, all right, January, come on, baby, here we go.
Mm-hmm.
And not a lot happened. And I thought, holy cow, what did I get myself into? Oh, my gosh, I can't. It's really February I feel like people spend a lot of time in January looking around going, okay, what am I going to do here? What's that? What's that? And they try a lot of different things. In February, if you are serious about those habits, that's kind of when you dig in.
And it used to be, you know, and I've joined different clubs over the last 40 some odd years. And every January, you'd get the people who never lifted a toe to exercise before. And they'd rush in on January 1st. And by this time, really, in, as you said, February, they were gone, never to be seen again.
You're not wrong. You're not wrong. But part of that is not having a plan in place. Because whenever you decide to exercise, there's a lot of change, right? We minimize it. We go, oh, I'm just going to start to exercise. It's no big deal. I'm going to do it for an hour a day. Wow, well, what used to go in that hour? And where's that going, what you used to do there? And who's affected by that? And how are they going to? I mean, you really have to plan for this ripple effect of change. And I think we're just so excited and so led by passion at the beginning of the year and that calling to start over again that we don't lay out a blueprint. And so that's one of the things that we encourage people to do is that, okay, let's make that change, but let's make it something realistic. Let's make it something that you can build upon, and let's make it something that is as least invasive as possible and will set you up for the most success.
And it's interesting because your Be Well Fitness, you have a lot of women who attend your classes.
Mostly, yeah.
It's got to be more difficult for women. You're a mother with a teenager, so and an active work life and other responsibilities going on. Is it more difficult for women to stay on a schedule like this because you still have all those other responsibilities?
Yeah, 100%. I think we, again, we're led by our passion. We're led by this calling to say, I need a change. But you have to be realistic and say it's not going to happen 5 days a week. You're not going to exercise. You know, if you're working full-time and you have a family to take care of and a home and other organizations and activities you're involved in, that workout is not going to happen 5 days a week for an hour. So instead of saying I'm going to do five or nothing, can you do two?
Two a week. Two a week.
Start there. Start with one a week.
Can you hear that enthusiasm? Can you imagine she's standing in front of your class and she's saying, you can do this.
You can do this. You can.
You don't have to do five days a week or every other day. It used to be that, right? Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, you got to hit the gym for a couple hours.
I mean, that's great. But I mean, if you're in a situation where you're at a base level where your level of activity, you are, you know, moderately inactive or sedentary or even stationary through your day. And a lot of us with what we do for a living now, right in front of that laptop, hours and hours and hours. So you have to start changing your mindset a little bit and say, you know what? Any movement is good. If I can get to the gym once a week, if I get to the gym twice a week, that's great. That's better than saying, well, I can't do five, so I'm not going to do any.
Well, tell us where Chris Cosky came from, because you were in radio for a long time. This is a sedentary lifestyle.
It sure
is. You sit there and you talk and people bring food in and there's parties and activities going
cake
on.
Cake
day. Yeah, it's cake day. So you've got all that working against you. So how did you parlay that into fitness?
Well, you know what? My son was really young. He was about, I think he was just over two when I corporate layoffs came in. I was at CBS Radio and I was laid off, and I have to say it was really a blessing in disguise. You know, I had a great career, I was making great money, but I really wanted to be home with my son. So it was a blessing in disguise. It was financially very tough, but the other hard thing about it was that as a woman who had been in my profession for already 20 years at that time, I kind of lost myself. And so I was at home with this toddler and I quickly started putting on weight. And even though I really wanted to be with him, part of my identity was gone. And I really started to spiral emotionally. I felt depressed. I put on a lot of weight. I had a few health scares. And so I found Be Well Nation, and it was with the previous owner. And I just really loved the culture there, which was, you know, of course, what I continue to build Be Well Nation upon today, which is, you know, you're okay here. You're safe to be here. You can work out. Nobody is going to judge you here. You know, long before the other place said it was a judgment-free zone, it was us.
Nobody's in there grunting and groaning, right?
No, I mean, and if you are, we don't worry about it.
Okay.
You know, no one's going to judge you. And I just loved that culture so much, and it just helped me change my perspective about my body image and my health and my and what I was capable of. You know, I was never an athlete. I was always, you know, a student right into radio, so sedentary lifestyle. So I was never an athlete. And all of a sudden, I'm doing these things that I never even thought I could be capable of doing. And so my passion and enthusiasm for what you're capable of and what you can do and how this makes you feel good, I just wanted to share with everybody.
Yeah. So in these in this period of time when John was like 2 years old and you're staying home and making breakfast and the radio's on in the background, were you ever tempted to say, and that's Stevie Nicks with Fleetwood Mac, and talk it up to the poster?
I just like to freak him out now because when we're in the car, I'll go, yeah, that's Stevie Nicks.
Yeah. Isn't that wonderful? Yeah, and you just came back from a cruise with the family, and you were talking about all the activities that, that you guys participated in. And did you do music trivia?
Well, yes, we did.
Yeah, yeah, were you the ringer? Did they count on you to? Yeah. What is that? I can name that tune in two notes.
It's a little bit of a sad skill set if you think about it. It's a little sad.
But you were able to do it.
Yeah.
So free drinks for everybody, right?
But you know what? The other thing about that vacation that I'll highlight is that when somebody comes to me or to any of our instructors and they talk about wanting to be healthy, you know, I was able to do things on this cruise that I'm so fortunate that I was able to do. I was able to hike anywhere I wanted. I was able to go on this crazy water obstacle course with my kid and and have the freedom to do it. And I want everyone to know that they can have the freedom to get down on the floor and play with their grandkids, to have the freedom to say, I'm going to walk the amusement park, I'm going to go on vacation and hike. That's what it's really all about. As soon as you let go of what you look like in that bathing suit or what size jeans you wear, it's a whole new world out there for the better.
Speaking of bathing suits, I'm just kidding. but yeah, so a lot of people, especially grandparents, would say, It's one thing to go down on the floor and play with the grandkids, but it's another thing to be able to get back up off of the floor.
Yes.
So
yes.
Is that something that you keep in shape for? I mean, you don't want to be winded, you know, when you're walking up the steps. Right. You don't want to, you know, you want to be able to go on those hikes. You want to go to the strip district without having to sit down every couple
That's
of
right.
blocks.
That's right. Without your feet hurting, your ankles hurting, your knees hurting. It's all about active, independent living and aging, about vibrant living, active aging, independent living. I think that's everything that we talk about. That's everything. Every once in a while, somebody will come in and say, you know, I want to look good for bathing suit season. I want to, quite frankly, okay, but that's boring. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'd rather have somebody who say, you know, I'm going to go on this fantastic trip and I want to be able to hike. So can you help me? Yes, we will. And that's, don't you feel like that's really like, you got to find your purpose.
Yeah. Because, and that's what they do at Be Well Fitness Nation, and we're going to talk more about that and a lot of other things in terms of getting in shape. And why is it that we always put that last? We have so many other things, and then as an afterthought, well, I really should get to the gym. I really should walk around the block.
I think, well, first of all, I think for women, it's a caregiver thing. I think we're naturally, we give care to everybody else and put ourselves last. But what we need to start thinking about, and all of us, myself included, you fall back into bad habits, and you have to remember, you have to take care of yourself and put yourself first, because what happens to all those people you take care of if you don't do it? If you're not in good health, what happens to all the people who rely on you? What happens to the people that you care for? So you have to keep that perspective as well and find that purpose. And sometimes that purpose is very emotional. It's very personal. You know, people have said to me through the years, you know, they'll say, well, because my doctor told me to. Well, that's not a good reason.
Yeah.
You find the purpose that you really want to maintain a healthy body.
And we're getting to that age. I'm not looking at Chris when I say that. We're getting
to
that age where you start to see people our age in TV and commercials and things like that, or people that your friends and family know, and they're bedridden or they're in a personal care home or something like that. And you say to yourself silently, dear God, please don't let me end up like that. And is it, you know, when you're staying in shape and you keep the parts moving?
Yeah. Well, I think another thing, you know, our lifespan is so much longer now. So you have to start thinking about, What does 70 look like? What does 80 look like for you? What do you want that to feel like? What does your 80 look like? You know, what is that 80 Is that 80 a walker? Mm. Is that 80 out on your own? Is that 80 still living independently, living with some help? You know, that's the way I kind of look at aging. You know, what did 50 look like for me? What will 60 look like for me? Now I'm looking at six, and now I'm like, I'm not quite mid 50s yet, but I look at it and I go, well, what is 60 going to look like for me?
Mm-hmm. Chris Cosky is our guest. Be Well Fitness Nation. Be Well Nation is her company, and we'll talk more about that. Healthy mind, healthy body, healthy spirit. Mm-hmm. It's all part of the St. Barnabas Radio Network. This is the best of Beaver County with Chris Cosky from Be Well Nation, and we'll continue on the St. Barnabas Radio Network.
When you think about retirement, what images come to mind? Why not let yourself imagine enjoying an exceptional retirement lifestyle at the Village at St. Barnabas in Gibsonia? Attainable luxury can become yours because the Village has no large upfront fees, and it's based on a simple annual no-risk contract. The only decision to make is when to move in. Call 724-443-0700 or click stbarnabashealthsystem.com.
Welcome back to the best of Beaver County on the St. Barnabas Radio Network. We are talking with Chris Cosky, fitness instructor and owner of Be Well Nation. Does that, you know, it still ring true? I mean, when you say, I say Chris Cosky, fitness trainer, fitness instructor, you say, is he talking about me?
I know, yeah. I know. You know what? It's funny how things change. It really does feel very natural now. I think because a lot of it is community and taking care of people, which was the one thing in radio, like radio is a fabulous life. You know, we make jokes about radio, but it really is, especially.
It's not work.
Right?
It's not like real work.
But the one thing that I kind of felt that was always missing was that community and caring for someone that I didn't know was a calling in me until it happened. So this does feel really natural. Still some of the physical stuff, I'm like, really, that's me? But yeah, for the most part, it does feel like a good fit.
Well, people, when they come to Be Well Nation, they're looking for help. They're looking for direction. They don't know how to do it on their own, and they need somebody. They need a trainer to help them at least begin this process.
Yeah, and a lot of the time, and this is our own fault in the industry, in the fitness industry, I feel like a lot of time they come to a gym, people come to a gym feeling like, I've been bad, I've been terrible, I don't know what I'm doing, I'm so uncoordinated. Like, they've just kind of been beaten down by whatever they've read or what they've seen or what they've heard. And it's just quite the opposite. You're coming in with this nice open book and that fresh page, and let's find out what you love to do. And that's one of the big things too, like, it's fitness mythology. You know, people come in and say, well, I have to do cardio. Well, do you like cardio? Nope, hate it. Well, then how? Like, yeah, first of all, you won't sustain that, right? If you're doing something, making yourself do something that you hate, it's not sustainable. So let's start with something you love to do. Do you love to stretch? Do you love to lift a weight? Mm-hmm. You know, let's start with something like that.
So, in other words, when somebody says, if you ever see me running down the street, there's probably a bear chasing me.
That's right. That's okay. To each their own. I get it.
But I see some of those people, like I come down to College Hill, and some of those college students are running, and they're like antelope. They're just so graceful in doing it.
Yeah. Not everybody has to run. Not everybody.
So, at Be Well Nation, when you go in there, am I going to be forced to do crunches and sit-ups and pull-ups and those sort of things?
No. We don't even have a pull-up bar. No. No. It's all a group exercise studio. Yeah. So, if you would come in, I would sit down with you, and everybody who's interested in a membership has a consultation with me. They can schedule a consultation. So anybody can come in and say, I'd like to see the place and meet with you. So we'll sit down, and the first thing I will ask you is, what do you like to do? Like, and what do you think you should be doing? And, you know, why are you here? And from there, I'll kind of assess what you're looking for, or maybe what kind of experiences you've had. I've certainly asked you what kind of experiences you've had, because a lot of people have had very poor experiences with fitness instructors and group exercise. You know, that whole, it almost becomes like that junior high lunch table bullying situation, the girls in the front row, blah, 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 which doesn't really happen at Be Well Nation, but people carry that. They even carry their experiences from high school gym class, and that emotions and bank of memories, and they're like, well, I've never belonged to a gym because I hated gym in high school. We all hated gym in high school. But after that, certainly going to ask you what kind of orthopedic concerns you have, health concerns you have, because that's one thing that really makes us different. We are a little smaller than, say, a big gym and their group exercise program. So if you tell me, listen, I have my right knee replaced, okay, well, then you're not going to do this, and we're going to have you do this instead of that. We can work with those different modifications and options for you so that you feel like you're getting the most out of your workout without being held back by anything that you feel has held you back in the past.
Sure. So a lot of people are suffering post-traumatic stress disorder from their teen years because they were the last ones picked for
it's
the
possible.
Team. They were getting hit in the face with a dodgeball and those sort of things. So they just said, I'm staying totally away from this stuff.
I was totally the girl in the bubble. I had chronic childhood asthma, allergies, you name it. So, I mean, there were times when I didn't even go outside. So I was that person. Yeah.
So do we set goals? Do people come in and say, you know, I gained 15 pounds over the last couple months, I want to get rid of those. Is that too lofty of goals?
No, I don't think so. But I think, you know, within my scope of practice, I would say to you, I'd ask you what you're currently doing now and what you like to do. And with most people, if they have not been exercising at all, I'll probably encourage them to try resistance training in some form, whether it's with a resistance band with us and we have some classes like that, or whether it's hand weights. I'll probably encourage them to go there because you need a little bit of core stability, core strength, and a little bit of body awareness before you start throwing yourself around the room in a cardio class. You know, and that's how bad backs happen. That's how limbs get strained. So we want to make sure you have a nice body awareness and you feel a little strength in your midsection all the way around, by the way, before we start telling you lift a leg and kick here and punch over there. We want you to feel confident and stable in what you're doing.
And people can go to your YouTube page or your website and you can see your classes in action, right? You can see some of
We do have a website. We have some short videos there that we post on Facebook and stuff.
So as we age and we're trying to get in shape, balance is an important part of that.
Fall prevention.
Mental. If you're exercising and you're doing, you know, any type of exercise, does that help your brain functions?
Absolutely. Anything where you're lifting one arm and one leg, you know, opposite arm, opposite leg, or you've got to think high, low, or there's so many different exercises that will help stimulate your brain. And any type of exercise, especially resistance training, is going to help with brain function and cognitive ability and all those things.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about core beliefs and community, because that's what you're all about. And your gym is located up in Patterson Township, right?
Yeah.
And so it's readily available to a lot of people.
Yep.
Are your classes sold out?
No.
No? So people can still take it on?
But like you said, you can drop in. Yeah, you can drop in anytime. Mm-hmm. You don't even have to be a member. You can walk right into a class.
What if you're a guy?
You can stop right there. What
Mark
if you're a guy?
Rally and, you know, you're intimidated by this class full of women. I got to go in there.
You know what? We have a handful of men who come to Be Well, and they're typically the spouses of some of the women who go there. Yeah. We've had some men who just walk in on their own. I would love more men to join us. I think men... I think a lot of men would enjoy group exercise. And you guys have been conditioned in a different way. Young men are conditioned much like young women now with body image and things like that. But men, you know, our age and a little older, you guys have been conditioned in a different way. My husband and I, we're like, because he's like, if you're not powerlifting, you're not doing anything.
Gotta work up a sweat.
Right?
Yeah.
But that's just not true. There's so many benefits to exercise and resistance training with a group where you typically use a lighter weight. That would still benefit you. You know, that core stability, the fall prevention, the balance, it would all. I'd love to see more men at Be Well. I won't lie.
Well, you know, I guess my generation, the people I used to work out with and stuff, it was. If you ended your 45 minutes or whatever and you weren't working up a sweat, then you really didn't put enough in.
Yeah. You'll still sweat.
That's not
you'll still sweat.
Yoga and
you'll
that kind
still
of thing.
Sweat. Yeah.
I hear that about yoga. And I know you have yoga classes as well, but I hear that, you know, even though it doesn't look that taxing, you're gonna work up a sweat.
Absolutely.
On that.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. To hold any of those positions, it can be a challenge.
What does community have to do with all this?
Community, you know, and it's kind of funny because one of the fitness trends for 2023 is community. And I feel like I just want to hand out party hats to everybody and go, welcome. Nice for you to join us. People want to work out with an encouraging group. They want to work out with people who are somewhat like-minded. I am very intentional about keeping politics, religion, politics, and politics out of the studio. I don't want to hear
How's
it.
How's that working out for you?
I don't want to hear it. I don't care about it. And nobody knows who or what I am, and that's by design. Because I want everyone to connect on a different level. Yeah. Encouraging one another, supporting one another, keeping one another accountable. Everybody kind of comes along with the same group of goals. which is to be healthy, which is to, you know, keep injuries at bay, which is to have a better future and a better quality of living and their activities of daily living. So community is really important to us. And it, I have to say, it really doesn't have a whole lot to do with me. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of like the curator. Mm-hmm. It's the group of people who work out there. You know, they're like interests. They could start a book club at any time. I see books flying around. Yeah. Like there's a book on a shelf. Oh, that's for her. Oh, there's a book over there. That's for her. Mm-hmm. Puzzles in the wintertime. I see we have puzzles up on the shelf right now. I'm like, who are these for? Mm-hmm. Summertime, they have vegetables. It's like a farmer's market in there. So our group, our community, they're really connected inside and outside the studio.
Yeah. Very good. Mm-hmm. And you're the referee. If somebody steps over the line, you're going to blow the whistle.
You know what? I'll say every once in a while. Yeah. It does happen. We're all human beings.
Okay, let's bring it back here now.
It's not a utopian society. It does happen.
Yeah.
But
exercise and diet, because mm-hmm. you just mentioned fruits and vegetables in the summertime. A lot of times in the winter, we don't have access to those good, fresh fruits and vegetables. Diet, an important part of all this?
It really is. Mm-hmm. It really is. And it crosses, you know, economic barriers, it crosses social lines. It's just, it's really important. And I think there's probably there's too much information out there. There's too much, you know.
Changes
you
all
can
the time.
Go on, right. You can go online and be so overwhelmed that you won't even know what to do. So I am not, and we don't, any of our instructors, we don't ever recommend a diet or an eating plan to someone. It's not in our scope of practice. You know, our scope of practice is exercise and movement and the benefits of. So we always recommend for people to consult a dietitian, because again, you know, you might know this person who's a health coach and they did a keto diet and man, it was great for them. But what if you have some sort of chronic condition or illness and a keto diet will make you more sick?
Yeah.
I don't know that because I don't have the education. So we always recommend a dietitian. Locally, the VGA Center for Obesity Medicine, they have a registered dietitian. Obviously, they have Dr. Zapaka who oversees the Obesity Medicine Center. And also, I found that Teladoc has online dietitians.
So it's online?
Yeah. So you can do virtual appointments with a dietitian.
Oh, nice.
Which makes it really easy, because if you're, you know, locally, your options may be limited in the county, and then you're going to maybe Cranberry or Boardman or Robinson, and that's a drive for some people. So that's a nice option. But I always say, especially with so many people, you know, with insulin resistance and type 2 diabetes and chronic illnesses, whether it's fibromyalgia, you know, conditions like, it could be anything. You really want a dietitian who understands what helps manage those illnesses and what hurts those illnesses.
But it sounds to me like Be Well Nation, it's just an inviting group, an inviting program that you encourage people to get involved with.
I would love for people to understand that exercise is not what they think it is. And it's really something that is good for your body and good for your mind. And it's not what you, if you feel like exercise is a chore, you know, just give it a shot and just try it from a different mindset, a different perspective of, you know, you're doing something good for your body and it doesn't have to feel like you're punishing yourself. That's the big thing. I feel like fitness and exercise for so many years has been viewed as a punishment and chore. Mm-hmm. We have to find the right way to do it. You have to give yourself a little bit of room and a little bit of grace and do that least invasive, most successful plan.
And Chris, I know that you speak of doing good, and I know Be Well Nation has done good in the community. Mm-hmm. You do a lot of fundraisers for people. In our last minute here, anything coming up?
No, we don't have any fundraisers planned for late winter, early spring. We don't have anything. We do have a Sweat With Your Sweetheart week coming up.
Oh, good.
It's an annual event all week. We invite people.
Sweat With Your Sweetheart.
Anybody you'd call sweetheart, bring them in. And your sweetheart, whether it's a partner, a friend, a coworker, a kid, niece, nephew, you can bring them in and they will work out for
and
free.
And can you break the myth that men are going to lose weight faster than women? Because women, you go on a diet the same time, you work out the same time as your significant other, and you lose, several pounds, and she's still struggling. And,
I don't know if I can break that myth.
No,
I don't
think.
It depends on a lot of different factors.
It depends on
what they're eating, what they're doing. It depends.
My wife always says, that's because God knew that we had to live longer, and we needed to persevere, so it doesn't matter if they lose all that weight. Chris Cosky, Be Well Nation. question. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you. This
as
was
always.
Fun.
Website or someplace
sure.
people can do that?
BeWellNation.com. And then we're also on Facebook and Instagram. You can find us under BeWellNation.
It's not too late. All right. It's the St. Barnabas Radio Program. It's the best of Beaver County. And we thank you for being a part of it. Remember, it's not too late. You can get started today.
Yes.
I'm Mike Romigh. Stay healthy. We'll see you next time.
Thank you for listening to the best of Beaver County. St. Barnabas is pleased to have provided content and sponsorship for the program. Tune in this Sunday at 11:30 for an encore presentation of today's program on Beaver County Radio. And next Thursday at 11 for another edition of the Best of Beaver County on WBVP, WMBA, and 99.3 FM.